Good morning, students. Welcome to my general knowledge class. My name is Flora, and I am going to teach you class 2 general knowledge. Today, we are going to study two different and very interesting topics. Topic 1, air and water, page number 20 to 21. And topic 2, inside me, page number 22. Both the topics are very interesting. So, let's begin. Topic air and water. In this topic, we will study about the daily needs of air and water in our everyday life. First of all, we will study about air. Air is one of the natural resources of our environment. Humans, animals and plants need air to breathe. When air moves, it is called wind. Yes, air is the natural resource of our environment, and we all, human beings as well as plants and animals, need air to breathe. And in what form we can see air? We can see air in the form of wind. When it moves, it is called wind. Water. Water is also one of the natural resources of our environment. Human, animals and even plants needs water. Water is colorless and also it has no shape. Yes, water is also a natural resource of our environment. Humans also need water, animals as well as plants. When we do the gardening, we give water to plants so that it can grow. And the color of water is colorless. No color is there. Even it has no shape. It is shapeless as well as colorless. Now, we will see some of the pictures of air and water. Pictures of use of air and water in different forms. As you can see, there are two columns, air and water. On the left hand side it is for air, and on the right hand side it is for water. So let's begin with air. In the first picture, you can see children flying the kite. In the second picture, you can see a boy is playing a flute. Third picture is showing us boy is playing with the balloon. Fourth picture is showing us a girl is playing with the bubbles. And in the last picture we can see a boy is kicking a ball. So these five activities need air. Playing of a kite, blowing air into the flute, flying of balloon, flying of bubbles, and even kicking of a ball. Now, we will start with the water. Water, as we can see in the first picture, a boy is swimming. In the second picture, a man is watering the plants. In the third picture, a lady is cooking food. In the fourth picture, boy and girl are drinking water. And in the fifth picture, we can see washing of fruits and vegetables. So these five activities also need water. Without water, these activities cannot be done. Now we will start with the explanation part. Again, you can see there are two columns. On the left hand side it is air and on the right hand side it is water. So we'll start with air. Number one, air is used to fly a kite. Air is used to blow air into the horn. Air is used to fly balloons. Air is used in flying of bubbles. Air is used in the kicking of a ball. With the help of air, we can do these activities. These activities requires air. On the right hand side, it is for water. Water is used for doing swimming, watering of plants, food for cooking food, for drinking water, for washing fruits and vegetables. So for these activities, what we require? We require water. Let's repeat it again. For air, to fly a kite, to blow air into the horn, to fly balloons, flying of bubbles, kicking of a ball. And in water, water is used for swimming, watering of plants, for cooking foods, for drinking water, and for washing fruits and vegetables. Now we will start with our worksheet. Question 1. Write the activities which require air. To fly a kite, to blow air into the horn, to fly balloons, flying of bubbles, kicking of a ball. I'll again repeat it for you. To fly a kite, to blow air into the horn, to fly balloons, flying of bubbles, and kicking of a ball. You have to write this question in your copies very neatly. Next question. Question 2. The underlying words are incorrect in the given sentences. Find the correct word from the given clues. Now, in the sentences, you can see there are some words which are being underlined. So, those underlined words are incorrect. What we have to do? With the given clue, we have to write the correct answer. So let's start. Air is a mixture of color. It is wrong. And what is the clue given? The clue starts with G. So air is a mixture of gases. Next. Moisture is in the air is called water bubbles. Wrong. Moisture in the air is called water vapor. Third, air also contains particles of silver, which is not good for our skin. Starts with D. So, what would be the answer? Air also contains particles of dust. Instead of silver, it would come dust. Dust, which is not good for skin. Fourth, we should breathe in dirty air. This is very clear. It starts with F. We should breathe in fresh air. Next, moving air is called river. Starts with W. So, moving air is called wind. Yes. I will repeat it again for you. Air is a mixture of gases. Moisture in the air is called water vapor. Air also contains particles of dust, which is not good for skin. We should breathe in fresh air. Moving air is called wind. Now you have to write this question in your copy very neatly. Question 3. Write the activities which requires water. Number 1. Water is used for doing swimming, watering of plants, for cooking food, for drinking water, for washing fruits and vegetables. I will repeat it again. Water is used for doing swimming, water for watering of plants, for cooking food, for drinking water, for washing fruits and vegetables. These are the things which require water. Now you will write this question also in your copy very neatly. Question 4. Choose the correct option. What we have to do? We have to choose the correct option in this question. So let's start. Number 1. Which is the most important source of water? Two options are given, rain or river. So the answer would be rain. Which is the most important source of water? Rain. Next, when water freezes, it turns into vapor or ice? Yes, ice. When water freezes, it turns into ice. How can we kill germs from water? By smelling or by boiling? By boiling. How can we kill germs from water? By boiling. Fourth, for which of these activities do you need water? For bathing or for reading? It is very clear. We need water for bathing. So, for which of these activities do you need water? For bathing. Next, when water is boiled, it turns into ice or steam? Steam. When water is boiled, it turns into steam. This question also you have to write in your copy. I hope you have understood the first topic. Now we will begin with our next topic. Our next topic is inside means पेज नंबर 22. दिस टॉपिक इज ऑल अबाउट अवर बॉडी एंड द ऑर्गन्स विच आर देयर इनसाइड अवर बॉडी. अवर बॉडी इज अ बिग मशीन. इनसाइड दिस मशीन देयर आर स्मॉल बॉडी पार्ट्स कॉल्ड ऑर्गन्स. देयर आर सम ऑर्गन्स विच आर आउटसाइड इन of our body and there are some organs which are inside in our body. The organs which are there inside in our body, they work and keep us alive. Let's take look on some of our important body. Number 1, heart. 2, bones. 3, muscles. 4, stomach. 5, lungs. 6, brain. I'll repeat it again. 1 is heart, 2, bone, 3, muscle, 4, stomach, 5, brain, and 6 is lungs. We will study these 6 organs in our next slide. Now I will explain you the 6 organs one by one. Explanation. Number 1, heart. Heart pumps blood in our body. It helps us to think fast, and because of that we can do our work easily. What heart do? Heart pump blood in our body and it helps us to think, and because of that only we can do our work easily and properly. Next is bones. Bones gives us shape to our body. Our body consists of 206 bones. That's why human body is so strong. What bones do? Bones give shape to our body. And how many bones are there in our body? There are 206 bones in our body. And that's why a human body is so strong. Third is muscles. Muscles help us to move. There are about 640 muscles in human body. Muscles are attached to bones. It helps us to maintain our posture or body position properly. What muscles do? Muscles helps us to move, and muscles are attached with bones. So both the things, bones and muscles, both the things work side by side. And there are how many muscles in our body? 640 muscles. What muscles helps us? It helps us to maintain our posture or body position straight, so we can walk or move properly. Next is stomach. Stomach helps us to store and break down food. It helps us to digest food easily. Stomach help us in what? It help us in digesting of a food which we are eating. Next is lungs. Lungs are like 2 bags in our chest. It help us to breathe properly through nose. Now here are 2 organs which we can see. First is lungs, which is the internal organ of our body, and second is nose, which is the external organ of our body, and both the organs are interrelated. Nose help us to breathe. Next is brain. Brain controls our body. It helps us to think and understand anything very easily. Brain is the main organ of our body and it controls our whole body. Head, eyes, nose, hands, legs, everything. And it is the organ which helps us to think and understand anything very easily. Now, we will start with our worksheet. Question. Read the clues and identify the parts. So, as we can see, some sentences are given with the clues. So, what we have to do? We have to understand the clues and write down the body part. I am the control center of your body. I help you to think. Brain. I am like two bags in your chest. I help you to breathe. Lungs. I pump blood to all body parts of your body. I work faster when you run or exercise. Heart. All food that you eat comes to me. It is digested here. Stomach. I give shape to your body. I am hard and 206 in numbers. Bones. I give you power and help you to move. Muscle. This question you have to write in your copies very neatly and properly. I hope students, you all have enjoyed and must have understood these both the topics. Now what I want to all of you, you have to write all the exercise in your copies very neatly and clearly. We will again meet soon in our online class. Till then, be safe at your homes and keep studying. Also, start learning your lessons, previous lessons. Thank you.